sin and I made up my mind. Wow, wow. What I decide?
What I decide?
I gotta grind.
Hey.
I gotta grind.
I gotta grind.
I gotta grind.
Grind.
I gotta grind.
Yeah, yeah.
All of the time.
Yeah.
24/7.
What the frick is up, YouTube? It's your boy Landon Miller, and we are back with another video today. This week it's gonna be a little bit of a change up I'm throwing at you guys. We're going with a shoe lineup video. I'm gonna just go through all the shoes I wear, what I wear them for, and why I like them. And yeah, we're gonna go from there. Last couple videos, y'all have been crushing on the likes, subscribes, all that stuff. So make sure you keep sharing these videos. Hit the like button. And make sure if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. We love you, for you guys to be a part of this ever-growing community, the Kill Elite community. We're on the rise and we're about to take over YouTube, so you know what it is. But anyways, yeah, I'm going to start out just going through the shoes I wear on a daily basis. Actually, before I start, in high school, a little background. High school, I used to wear pretty much only, I wore Brooks trainers. I only wore the Brooks Launch. Those are the only trainers I'd wear. And then I'd wear the Saucony Fast Switch for flats, and then spikes I'd always wear the New Balance spikes. That's kind of what I went with until I got to college, and then started trying some other things, and I've become pretty much a Nike shoe guy, except for recently I really like the Adidas flats. But yeah, to start out with, the two shoes I wear for my daily trainers, the bulk of my mileage, Pegasus 36, Pegasus 37. My favorite Pegasus were the 34s, but I mean, those are hard to come by nowadays. But yeah, actually the 36s are, these ones are a little bit rougher shape. I think they have close to 500 miles on them, but yeah, I like to wear these for a lot of mileage. These shoes only weigh 8.9 ounces, 10 millimeter heel drop, which is pretty standard. I like my training shoes to be a little bit less. I don't like much shoe, so I prefer my shoes to just kind of be on the lighter side, which the Pegasus does. And then the Pegasus 37, I have really grown fond of these bad boys. I usually wear these the day before and the day after workouts just because of the React foam that they have in the midsole. These are 9 ounces, which is 0.1 ounces more than these shoes, so really not much of a difference. But these come packed with the React foam in the midsole, which I think is really helps. It's easier on your legs, allows you like just get your legs prepped for a workout better, and it helps them recover better the day after workout. So I love these two shoes. Bulk of my mileage is done in between these two shoes. I know usually with trainers like these, I try to push them to 600 miles, but I mean, you just got to be careful. Watch the tread on the bottom. And I mean, you just kind of have that feel of when you know a pair of shoes is shot. Then this brings me to my pair of Adidas SL20s. These are actually probably the favorite pair of shoes I own. I always liked running in lighter shoes for long runs. And these are 8 ounces with a 6 millimeter heel drop. So they're actually really flat, which is another thing that I really enjoy about them for long runs. I pretty much solely wear these for long runs. I would wear them for tempos, but I have carbon fiber shoes, and that's usually what I wear for tempos. But yeah, absolutely love these shoes. They got the Adidas Light Strike foam throughout, which is what helps take some of the weight off. And their tread, they actually partnered with Continental Tire for the tread on the shoes. And these things are really good. They're actually kind of getting kind of shot too. But yes, I really... These mimic the Nike Zoom Elite 10s, which that's actually probably my favorite all-time shoe. I wore the crap out of those. I had like 4 or 5 pairs of them, but unfortunately Nike stopped making them because they have better marathon shoes than those now. But yeah, these bad boys pretty much only wear them for long runs, but when you're running 16-mile long runs every week, the mileage builds up fast. And then, like I said, for tempos, I break out the Next Percents. These shoes... absolutely love the heck out of these shoes. Little over 100 miles on them, and they're still holding together. I'm gonna try to push them as far as I can. I don't know how long the tread on the bottom will last, but yeah, really love these shoes. Definitely, they're really expensive. I'm probably not gonna get another pair when they run out. I think my next carbon fiber shoe that I'll buy for tempos, I'm deciding to either go with the Zoom Fly SP3 or I've heard lots of really good things about the Hoka carbon fiber shoes. I think it's the Rocket X is what they're called, but yeah, I'm going to try to decide between those two shoes the next time that I get a carbon fiber, which should be sometime this spring. This brings me, these are my flats. If you notice, both of my flats or lighter shoes are Adidas. I think Adidas kills it with the flats. These are their RC 2.0, which are kind of a lesser soled shoe. Sole as in like, you don't see them on many people's feet. But I really like these. These suckers are about out too. I really want to go with the Adios 5 next, but I don't know what Adidas does with their restocks and everything, because they're always sold out of everything. But anyways, yeah, these RC 2.0, they're actually really light, 7.1 ounces. So these are what I'm wearing pretty much every time we do an interval workout on the track, anything fast like that. These are the suckers I put on my feet just because they're light. So I love minimal feel. I used to be a huge fan of the Nike Streak 7s and the LT4s. Both of those shoes are absolutely phenomenal, but I kind of like these because they're a little bit more structure, and the Streak LT4s were, like, I had some foot problems with those, especially on the indoor track, just because literally they're not a shoe. That's just a thin slice of rubber between your feet and the ground. But this is a little more shoe, so it gives you a little more support. Definitely Adidas flats. Those things rock. I love those things. And then obviously you have to have a pair of UFO slides if you want to recover properly. If you're a runner and you're going to try to recover properly, you need the UFO slide. These things freaking slap. I wear them all the time. Probably going to have to get a new pair soon because these things are actually, I'm wearing the crap out of these things. I got them sometime over the summer, I think. Yeah, so that's kind of my training shoes. And now we'll get into the racing shoes. As you guys have seen on the channel, I mean, just got the new Dragonflies a couple weeks ago. Absolutely love these things. To quote my man Aaron Beck again, these are another pair of shoes that make it feel like you have sex on your feet. But yeah, these shoes, I'm really excited because next week I'll be running a 3K at our home track meet, and I'm really excited to see what I can do in these. Like I said before, the Pebix plate with the Zoom X midsole, these shoes are freaking great. And then the other two pairs of shoes, I got the Nike Mamba 5s. These are the Bowerman edition, actually. I got these last year for the steeple, but I wore them for everything last year. And they're an absolutely great spike. They're obviously cheaper than the Dragonflies now. So, I mean, if you need a good all-around spike, but you don't want to drop money on the new Victories or the Dragonflies, these are definitely the route to go. They're so versatile, anything from the 15 to the 10K. And then plus they have a super breathable mesh up top, which is very key for the steeplechase. But yeah, so I'll be wearing these pretty much primarily for steeples this year. I don't know what else I'd wear them for, because I'd wear the Dragonflies for essentially everything else. And then that brings me to my last pair of spikes, which are the Zoom Victory. I believe these are the 3s. Yeah, I wear these for cross, actually. So these are a 1500, 800 spike. But because of the plastic plate that comes all the way back to the midsole, I really like these for cross because you get that extra grip. But I've also been wearing I wore them for the 8 this week, or this past week. And then, I mean, when I run 1200 leg in the DMR, I mean, I'd be deciding between these shoes and the Mambas to wear. But I really like these for cross. Get you plenty of grip, plus they're just light as heck. I don't really like cross-country specific spikes. I think that they give you too much shoe. I just like the absolute bare minimum, and that's what these give. Plus, they're super aggressive, so you can throw them on the track if you're doing something really fast. So these kind of dual-purpose shoe for me. And then, you know, one other thing that I got, living in Indiana, you got to get yourself a pair of Yak Tracks. These suckers are a lifesaver anytime it snows or ice, because you got the little, I don't know what they are. They're like these little studs on the bottom. I don't know if you can see them, but it actually works really well. You just slip them over your shoes, and then every time you're stepping in, you get these six little picks that are going to grab onto the ice for you, and you're not going to slip. It actually, I mean, It seems like it's so simple that it shouldn't work, but it actually really does. And it's saved my arse a few times running when we get icy or snowy conditions out. And last but not least, I don't actually wear these for running, but these are specifically designed to be barefoot running shoe sandals. Actually, these are made by Zero Running Shoes. I absolutely love the frick out of these things. They're so comfortable. They come with this foam here on the forefoot and midfoot that is called Cloud Foam. But they're literally the most comfortable things. When it's warm enough, I will wear these all the time. So I highly recommend getting a pair of these things. They're technically called barefoot running sandals. They're styled actually after, if you've read the book Born to Run, the Tarahumara Indian tribe, that they're like world renowned for their distance endurance running abilities. They make sandals out of like tires, and essentially these are what those are modeled after, but a little extra technology thrown in on top. Love these things. I'm not joking. These are literally my favorite shoes ever. I call them my Air Jerusalem 4s just because they look like Jesus sandals. But yeah, so as you can see, these are all my shoes. These are what I wear. Gonna be changing here soon, so I'm gonna have to replace these 36s here soon and the RC 2.0s and the Next Recents. Running shoes are expensive. I'm not much of a sneakerhead, but I have a lot of running shoes, as you can see. But yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. Let me know what your favorite running shoes are down in the comments. Let me know what are in your shoe arsenal. And yeah, thanks for watching this video. Make sure to give it a thumbs up. Make sure to hit the subscribe button if you're not subscribed. Stay tuned for next week. We're going to have an absolute banger coming out with the 3K. I think I'm doubling back in the DMR because we're trying to get that qualified for Nationals too. So that's going to be another hype race week. Let me know what you thought about this video down in the comments. And make sure, hey, you know, it's the start of indoor season. But you still got to keep prepping for outdoor season. You got to stay locked in. You got to keep that poise. And then when your meets start happening, just, you know, you got to man up and freaking perform. But thanks for watching. Make sure you like, subscribe, and we will see you next week. Yo, so I want to do something for all y'all killers that watch all the videos all the way through the end. And so what I want is, if you're still watching, you got a question for me, any kind of question, just drop that in the comments. And in the next couple videos, in the outro, I'll pick a question and answer that question. So yeah, make sure you drop a question down in the comments. Like, subscribe. Thanks y'all for watching. Peace. I'm so reborn. I'm moving forward. Keep moving forward. Keep moving forward. Ain't no stress on me, Lord. I'm